Sayyid Mahdi Bahr al-Ulum was one of the greatest Shia scholars of his time. In the book called Fawaid al-Rijaliyya by Sayyid Mahdi Bahr al-Ulum, it is narrated that one day Sayyid Mahdi Bahr al-Ulum, along with his students, was walking through the streets of Karbala. As he and his students were walking, they came across a group of mourners that were grieving over Aba Abdullah al-Hussein. And whilst they were grieving, the students noticed that these group of mourners were passionately and vigorously beating their chest. The students looked at those group of mourners with scorn and disgust. Suddenly, they noticed that Sayyid Mahdi Bahr al-Ulum, who moments ago was by his side, had suddenly taken off his turban, unbuttoned his shirt, and joined the group of mourners, and he also started beating his own chest vigorously and passionately. The group of students all came and tried to control and subdue Sayyid Mahdi Bahr al-Ulum, but to no success. When the group of mourners departed that area, and when they finally were able to stop Sayyid Mahdi Bahr al-Ulum, they asked, "Oh Sayyid Mahdi Bahr al-Ulum, you are one of the greatest Shia scholars of the time. You are one of the authorities of the time. What is it that overcame you that you are also doing matam, beating your chest vigorously and passionately in an undignified manner?" The horrified students asked this question to Sayyid Mahdi Bahr al-Ulum. Look at the response of this Sayyid. Look at the beautiful response. Sayyid Mahdi Bahr al-Ulum turns towards them and he says that when I came closer to the group of mourners, I saw my Imam doing the same as what they were doing. So how could I stop myself? I saw that my Imam had his head uncovered and he also was grieving over Aba Abdullah al-Hussein with them. And so I couldn't stop myself, and I also joined them in their ranks and started beating my chest passionately and vigorously. Subhanallah, brothers and sisters, in the nights of Muharram, we too will be joining the ranks and we too will be striking our chest for the grief and love out of Aba Abdullah al-Hussein. Let us remember that we will not be alone in this great act, but rather the Imam of our time, the Imam of our age, will also partake in this action, and he too will be amongst our ranks in beating his chest for his grandfather. Let us not be shy in beating our chest passionately for Imam Hussein alayhi salam. Just like the CPR of the doctors of a dying heart, whenever we raise our hand to strike out of grief for Imam Hussein alayhi salam, let us remember that this strike is a strike to revive and recover our hearts spiritually. It is like a CPR of our hearts spiritually.